up, he's always there, fighting for freedom over land and air. G.I. Joe!
G.I. Joe is the code name for America's daring, highly trained special mission force. Its purpose? To defend human freedom against Cobra, a ruthless terrorist organization determined to rule the world.
He never gives up. He'll stay till the fight's won. G.I. Joe will dare. G.I. Joe.
Histeria presents The Andrews Sisters between 1925 and 1967.
He should do well with this nose of his.
Well, the next thing I know, Abe was elected president, and they put his picture in the paper. He had grown a beard! So, one day when the president was on his way to the White House, his train stopped in my town, and he asked for me.
Ooh, that's this bone. Oh, maybe that too.
Bones! She would never miss Valentine's Day on purpose. Something must have happened.
Thank you.
On September 1774, Pepper and Ma are getting ready for the horse ride all around the country world.
Yes, I'm the very first mammal clown, you know. You may call me Dolly.
No, call me Dolly.
No, me.
No, I am.
No, I am.
I'm the first mammal clown.
Yeah, right. You're the
best. The beard was pretty cool, right, Abe? Now, how about trying some new threads?
It is so you, honest Abe.
At 37, he was elected to the U.S. Congress.
But what if we can't see the whites of their eyes?
Don't you know it's gonna be all right?
Oh, okay.
Hey, you're Lotus Kittikus.
I am? Hey, I am.
And they elected Jefferson Davis of Mississippi as their president. And leading the charge for the South was General Robert E. Lee.
I am. It was during the Song Dynasty that rice became a popular dish.
Suffice to say the rice is nice, just try it. It's quick and oh so basic to our diet. Rice! Hey, Mr. Tesla! What's this button do?
So, Jibbalina, why don't you show us how they're making this new constitution?
Thus, the beginning of time, Pepper Mills and Mal Kiddington goes on the country world for the ride.
It's time once again for Double Date with your host, Pepper Mills and Mal Kiddington.
Hi, I'm Pepper Mills. You know, working on Histeria, I've gotten to meet some of the biggest names in the world.
Relax, everybody. Look what Frogo made. At 34, he ran for the U.S. House of Representatives and lost.
Okay, like Romulus and Remus's royal dad was Mars.
We're going to get letters.
I'm an eagle, sir!
But it doesn't stop there. That's not all. There are amazing coincidences. I just have to say that I'm a huge fan of all your movies. On
the Louisiana Territory, 828,000 square miles of North America, stretching from the Mississippi River to the Rocky Mountains. Juan Ponce de Leon, who explored Spain in 1513!
Then, like, Amulius threw his nephews, Romulus and Remus, into the mighty Tiber River to get rid of them. Shaw, totally bogus.
But it doesn't stop there! That's not all!
Then, there was Brutus! Oh, I love him even more!
One day, when the president was on his way to the White House,
train stopped in my town, and he asked for me.
Here's a part-time leather tanner from Seville who's back for round two. Say hello to Senor Toast. Hey, lady, I need a book.
Would you mind running that by us again in English?
It means what a bummer!
No, what the time dude said.
He said some companies got so big that little companies couldn't compete with them.
Oh.
And that's not good.
The complete and unabridged history of Greenland.
Hey, Barry, we just wanted to call and show some support for our stablemate there. Yeah, and we wanted to tell everyone watching that there's no way she had anything to do with this terrible fire.
That's all. And we'll be back with more next time on
Histeria.
Barry, it's feeding time. Hey, we're off.
Histeria proudly presents a dramatic reading of Mary Had a Little Lamb 2000.
Mary had a little lamb, but she really wanted two.
And thanks to genetic research, she knew just what to do.
Scientists took the DNA from Mary's lamb and said,
we'll make a carbon copy and a lamb clone will be bred.
So a brand new lamb was born and people called it Dolly.
Mammal cloning's first big star.
Or mankind's biggest folly.
Or if we start to clone ourselves, aren't we playing God?
Creating some master race with perfect face and bod?
If today we clone a lamb, how long will it be till someone decides to clone himself and not clone you and me?
So the next time Mary's little lamb comes walking down the way, admire its fleece as white as snow and not its DNA. Thank you! Thank you!